everyone, welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before your holy presence asking forgiveness of my sins so that my prayer can enter your throne. Father, I thank you for the day that you have given us and the week that we have started. Father, I ask that you will continue to guide us and direct us in your ways. Continue your transformation work in our lives. Lord, we need you. We depend on you. We strive to be like your Son. We strive to do your will. Father, I ask that you will guide us and protect us from the evil one, Lord. Allow us to see the snares that are put in front of our steps. Allow us to see where the evil one is being cunning and thrifty and trying to trip us up. Give us that wisdom, Father God, to recognize what is from you and what is not from you. Father, these things I ask in your Son's name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, From Simon to Peter. It was written by John Ruano and translated by Nelson Berries. Our biblical base comes from John chapter 1, verse 42. So says the word of God. And he brought him to Jesus. Now when Jesus looked at him, he said, You are Simon of the son of Jonah. You shall be called Cephas, which is translated a stone. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. I want to highlight Simon's will, courage, decision, respect, and good expressions. In the process, I admire him because he listens to his master's strong words and is not scandalized, as when Simon tells him, Far be it from you, Lord, this shall not happen to you. But he turned and said to Peter, Get behind me, Satan. How would we feel if Jesus spoke to us like this? However, Simon is still there. He is worthy to imitate. Simon enjoyed many privileges with his Lord. Jesus washed his feet, took him to the house of Jairus, head of the synagogue, where he saw his wonders. But something more beautiful happens. He is taken to the mountain where Elijah and Moses appear, to see how the Lord is transfigured, where his clothes shone, to be in a place where the other nine disciples were not. In Matthew 16:16-17, I have always loved his confession. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. But Simon wants to defend his beloved Jesus with his strength and sword, but the cause is defended with the dedication of soul, body, and spirit. From Simon to Peter until he died for the cause, that is the Peter that the Master wants. Are you still Simon, or are you on the path of Peter? Amen. My brothers and sisters, Simon led a life that we could follow as example. His passion and zealousy for Jesus was admirable. But don't forget, our goal is to be more like Jesus and less like anybody else. Simon set a very good example of how we should follow God, how we take reproach and corrective criticism, how we take when we are being disciplined. But following Christ is the greatest reward, following in his footsteps. When you follow in his footsteps like Simon did, then you are going to see the wonders and miracles of our Lord and Savior. You are going to witness God's mighty hand at work. You are going to experience his favor and his blessing. And you are going to be guided down a path that is so wonderful that you could not have even planned it yourself. My brothers and sisters, are you like Simon in the beginning? Or are you striving to be more like the Peter? Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
Change my heart, O God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, O God. May I be like you. Change my heart, O my heart, oh God, may I be like you. You are the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make. This is what I pray. Change my heart, oh God.
Come change my heart.
Make it ever true.
Make it ever true.
Change my heart, oh God.
Come change my heart.
May I be like. Change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God, may I be like you.
Amen. What a beautiful song. And now, my brothers and sisters, once again, we invite you to check out the YouTube channel, SCC English Ministry is the name, for our daily Bible reading as we continue through the book of 1 Kings. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.